Good morning, students. Today I am just continuing the subject accountancy, and the yesterday topic was bookkeeping and accountancy. Bookkeeping and accountancy. This is the full name of the subject, bookkeeping and accountancy, and this is one part and this is another part. I am just revising it, that the whole subject is divided into two parts. Of course, the first part is has also two words, bookkeeping, and the main meaning of bookkeeping is recording of business transactions. Accountancy also includes recording of the business transactions, but the meaning of accountancy is vast. It is recording, it is analyzing, it is summarizing, and it is processing so many things. But bookkeeping, which is a part of accountancy, is recording of business transaction, which is already taught yesterday. But once again I am explaining this term, transaction. The transaction has a special meaning any business activity with monetary value is known as transaction. My dear student, any business activity with monetary value or the financial or the economic value, which can be defined with the term of money, is known as transaction. Yesterday I have already explained in detail. Today only I will write some transactions. Transactions I will write, after that I will go for the double entry system. So, bookkeeping is recording of the business transactions, and for the recording of the business transaction in accountancy subject or in the commerce field, we have a system, recording system is required for recording of the business transactions. That is required. So recording system that is followed in the accountancy, that is known as double entry system. If you have seen my previous video, already I have explained all this thing. Double entry system, and in the double entry system, the main thing, each transaction has two folds. Folds are effects. This is the main thing of the double entry system, that each transaction has two folds or two effects, or in each transaction, two accounts are affected. Two accounts are affected. This is already taught yesterday, but I am revising here. Two accounts are affected. As I write here, the same transaction, Rakesh started his business with cash rupees 20 lakhs. This is a business activity and this is called a transaction. This is a clear example of the transaction business activity. Rakesh started his business. This part is the activity and this part is the monetary value or financial character. This part is its monetary character. And as I have written here, any business activity with monetary value is known as transaction. So this is the activity and this is the monetary value. That is the financial character. Cash rupees 20 lakh. So this becomes a transaction. And here, this transaction will be recorded in the register that is called books. So when we record the transaction and we follow the double entry system, my dear, so we have to find out the two faults or two effects or two accounts which are affected in this transaction. So here I am just writing here that in this transaction, cash account is affected. This is the first effect. That the in the business will record the or maintain the cash account. Cash account. Account is a record. So whenever cash is affected, so cash account will be affected. And the second account, because Rakesh has started the business, Rakesh is businessman, so his account will also be maintained in the business. I would like to tell you the same thing, that this big circle is business. And the another circle I am making, that is, this is the small circle. This is business man. This is Rakesh. The recording of the business transaction, that is done for the business, not for the Rakesh. Not for Rakesh. All the transactions are recorded for the business. This is the transaction of business. This transaction will be recorded here in the business with its two effects. So, what are the two effects in the big circle, that is business? That first thing, cash account will be affected, and the second, Mohan account will be affected. Mohan's account will be affected. These are the two affected account. Mohan's account. Listen, in double entry system, which is a very popular system and followed by all the sole traders or the company, etc., we do not write the name of trader. This is trader or owner. Mohan is trader. Instead of Mohan's account, capital account is maintained. So the second account, that is not Mohan's account, but instead of that, the capital account. capital account will be maintained in the business. My focus is over the recording of the business transaction, and I am clearly speaking that the transactions are recorded for the business, not for the businessman. It is the separate unit. All the business transactions are recorded for the business. Mohan or the businessman is a party whose account is maintained into the books in the business. So here I have explained one transaction. Now I will write so many transactions, and I will tell you about the two effects of the each transaction. My dear, you write the transaction in your notebook and write the effects for your practice. When you write these sentences, you will come across through the different terms of the accountancy. As I have written here, cash account, capital account. I will explain the capital account later on. In detail, I will explain what is capital. Actual capital is the investment of Rakesh. That is invested here. So I will explain you. Here I am just writing some transactions, different transactions of a business, and their two effects. Transactions and their two effects. Same transaction I am writing here. Transactions. Rakesh started his business with a capital. Slightly I have changed the word capital. With a capital rupees 20 lakh. As 20 lakhs. As I have explained this transaction, that there are two effects. One and two. Here I am again mentioning double entry system. Double entry system. In double entry system, each transaction has two effects, and the first one is cash account, and the second effect is capital account. If you write this many times, automatically you will learn about the two effects. Dear, this is the second transaction. Purchased a machine costing rupees 10,000. See, purchased a machine. Here I have not written Rakesh purchased. Means the machine is purchased by business, not by Rakesh. Of course, he is the owner of the business because he has started the business. He is the investor. He has invested the money into the big circle which I have explained here. Purchase a machine costing rupees 10,000. This is a business transaction. This is the activity, purchase a machine, and costing rupees 10,000 is its monetary term or the financial character. So when this transaction happens, so two accounts will be maintained in the big circle in the business, that is machine account. This account will be maintained. If we are purchasing machine, we have to maintain the machine account. If we are purchasing computer, computer account. If we are purchasing furniture, furniture account. So this account will be affected. And the second effect, that cash is affected. Cash account, that 10,000 will be, see, this is business. Again, I am explaining. So here one record, that machine account will be maintained, and the second is cash account, that is affected here. You simply see the machine that will come into the business and cash that will go out from the business. Very simple. When a machine is purchased, that comes into the circle, and the circle is business, and cash which is received from Rakesh 20 lakh, out of that 10,000 cash is going out. You have to learn this movement or this circulation. So here I have just explained. So cash account will be affected. Here third number, purchased goods worth rupees 30,000. See, my dear, this term is explained in my previous video. Goods, purchase goods and purchase machine. Machine is purchased in the business to make the proper use, regular use in the business. But the goods is that item, that commodity, which is purchased in the business to sell it again. Yesterday I have told you. It is for resale. It is for sell it again. So when goods, here I am just writing the classification of goods for your simple knowledge. Classification of goods. Goods account, you can say. Classification of goods account. The first one, purchases account. Purchases account. The second, sales account. Sales account. Purchases, returns account. And fourth, sales returns account. And fifth is opening stock. And the sixth one is closing stock. Goods account is divided into six parts. Purchases account, sales account, purchases returns account, sales returns account, opening stock and closing stock. These are the six parts. Here I have written purchase goods. So I will show the two effects. Purchases account will be affected. Purchases account will be affected. And the second thing, the cash account again affected. Very simple. When we are purchased, when business has purchased goods, goods will come into the business and cash will go out from the business. Fourth number, sold goods worth rupees 15,000. don't think about the amount. Any amount I can write. I can write rupees 150 also. Sold goods worth rupees. When word goods is there and it is sold, so account, sales account will be maintained. So the first effect, that will be cash. When we sell goods, when business has sold goods, cash will come and goods will go out. So cash account, and the second, sales account. Now the fifth, I am just writing another transaction related to this. Purchased furniture. Furniture of rupees 5,000. When goods is purchased, purchases account. When goods is sold, sells account. But when furniture is for the use of the business. So here, furniture account will be maintained. Furniture account and the second cash account. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here I have explained 5 transactions. You only think over these transactions. Tomorrow I will explain the same transactions along with some more new transactions. I will just divide the type of transaction. Now I have explained only the cash transactions. I will explain you about the credit transaction. So this is very enough for today. You make the notes, take the help of books, and try to practice. Try to find out the two effects of the transaction. Thank you very much, my dear. Have a nice day.